Welcome back. On census night, there were 645 people aged 100 or older living in New Zealand. The oldest of them, 109. Our population is getting older, we all know that. So does that mean we need to rethink the way we care for the elderly? Broadcaster Mark Sainsbury thinks so. After years of listening to sad stories of neglect in our rest homes, he's lobbying MPs to appoint a commissioner for the elderly. Top leader and economist Geoff Simmons says baby boomers already have plenty of supporters. Good evening to both of you, and thank you very much for being here. Mark, I'll start with you first. You would have listened to many compelling stories. Mm-hmm. What is it about this one that got you and prompted action?
Well, it was one particular woman, Karina O'Brien, who rang up. And like many people in the situation where they discover there's abuse or they're worried about the care of the elderly, don't know where to go, don't know what to do. She was amazing, this woman. She chased it down. Her father, they found him having maggots plucked out of his toes in a rest home. He had issues, health issues, and they had this thing called bed blocking, so they moved them into rest homes. And, OK, what the thing was with this was that she went to the Health and Disabilities Commissioner, she went to the DHB, she went all over the place. And I think one of the investigation, they came back 18 months later to tell them, oh, yes, there's merit in this. She found there was no single focus. You know, we have a retirement commissioner, we have a health and disabilities commissioner, we have the ombudsman is now has new powers for people who are compulsorily put in. And more people rang in and people were frightened. People are saying, if this could happen to someone who had a caring family looking after them, who's there standing up for me? And that's we decided there should be a champion. And this wasn't a new idea, it wasn't my idea. Grey Power had been fighting for it for years. Labor, the Greens and Grey Power went on the road and said in the first, in fact, it was David Clark said, in the first Labor-led budget, we will have an aged care commissioner. So everyone's in the right space, but nothing is happening.
And Geoff, doesn't Mark have a point? If this situation could happen, isn't the system failing?
Well, yeah, acknowledge that this situation is not acceptable, should be investigated and sorted, totally agree. But we need to put it in perspective, you know. Health and Disability Commissioner gets 144 of these sorts of complaints every year. Compare that to, say, 40,000 homeless people we have. I mean, where's their advocate? You know, we have children, rates of poverty amongst children are 8 times higher than they are for the elderly. If we're going to focus on a particular group that needs help, I don't think the elderly are going to be the first port of call.
Yeah, but there's no point saying just because this group doesn't have one, we don't give one to this. There is a children's commissioner. Ideally, I would like a commissioner, whatever you decide to call it, to be like the environment commissioner, to be an officer of parliament, because there's only 3 officers of parliament. There's the environment commissioner, there's the auditor general,
But do we need that other layer of bureaucracy,
well,
though? That's the thing.
We don't need... Look, this is where we do agree. We don't need layers of bureaucracy. So you need someone with the power to do something. And that's why, when you look at the Environment Commissioner, where they're an officer of Parliament. They're not subject to the whims and wants of the various parties. And I think it's important enough. And it's not... They should be there not just to solve every little problem in a rest home or whatever. They should be there to advocate for our seniors.
And Geoff,
but we already have Winston. Yeah. We already have Winston advocating for our seniors.
Winston's not going to live forever.
We have no party in Parliament that's willing to reform superannuation, New Zealand superannuation, which is clearly unaffordable. I mean, we have plenty of advocates for the elderly in our Parliament right now because they're the ones that vote. It's young people that are currently getting the rough deal.
But if they've got it so good, Geoff, why does these things still keep happening? The problem is, yes, you've got... I mean, this is the thing that got me the most. You're quite right. There's Winston advocating for the elderly, and New Zealand First, it's long been their major platform. You've got the Greens and Labor saying, yes, we're going to do something, and yet nothing happened.
Because, Geoff, isn't this the perfect time? We've got the ageing population. Wouldn't it make sense to have one person representing this group?
Well, not when we have twice as many working poor as we... If you're working, you're twice as likely to be in poverty than if you're retired. You know, we have the lowest rates of poverty amongst the elderly in the whole Western world. I really... You know, if you are going to worry about any particular group in society, I don't think it's going to be the elderly.
But does he have a point? Because do we need a commissioner for the middle-aged?
Well, he could have a commissioner for everything. Look, the fact of the matter is, yes, we look at the numbers, and yes, it's a separate debate, the super debate. Most people agree it is unaffordable. But that's and there's the politics involved in that. But if you look at the elderly population, not everyone is on the same level. I mean, we get it gets evened out. This is what everyone, you know, those awful averages of what everyone's earning. There are still large groups of people who struggle. Lots of people, lots of senior citizens have a very nice, comfortable life. They're on fantastic facilities that look after them. Not everyone's in that situation. And there's that. And I wonder, I know that Geoff mentioned it could be because I'm approaching retirement age, whether that could be the fact. But you do notice as you age, you become invisible. And despite you look at them and think, this group should have the most political power.
Surely
imagine
not
if they
you,
all voted
though, Mark.
Top.
But surely you're not invisible.
the elderly are not invisible to politicians. That's the one group that politicians are absolutely most focused on because, like I said, they are the ones that vote. That's why no one will touch super. You know, when you come to retire, Jessica, you're going to be paying 5 cents in every dollar more to pay for Mark's health and superannuation costs.
And is it a case of these baby boomers wanting it all?
Oh, well, absolutely, I think so. I mean, we have this situation, like I said, it's just a matter of scale. There's always going to be things that go wrong and absolutely they need fixing. But in terms of systemic issues in society, how we treat our elderly is not one of them.
Because isn't that the point, though? In Parliament, when you look at the makeup of Parliament, their voices are heard every day in the debating chamber.
In which case there's no problem, is there? We shouldn't have a problem. I mean, I know Geoff said there's all these MPs. Surely their job is to do that. The fact of the matter is they have other things to do. They get distracted and Parliament's change, which is why my initial idea was to have is it a parliamentary office. So they survive the political currents. So as governments change, they're still that advocate. I guess what it was when the people who were talking to me are just saying, we don't know where to go. There was no one there. Yes, there was politicians who advocate, but there was no one in the system. So if it's the bureaucracy we're worried about, then pare it back. I mean,
what about Grey Power, though? Are they not doing their job
properly?
No,
Grey Power have been fighting for this, and they thought they had a deal. Grey Power were not happy that when the first budget came along, they didn't get what had been promised. They were on the road with Labor and the Greens.
But shouldn't they be that voice?
Well, no, you need someone. You need someone with the power, either to, like with the Commissioner for the Environment who reports to Parliament, or someone... Look at Andrew Beecroft. Look at the issues he's raised over children. He has a voice, and it's a respected voice.
And like I
voice.
Said, children have 8 times the rate of severe poverty than the elderly. I mean, the Health and Disability Commissioner inspects 80% of these residential care facilities. What more do you want?
Well, you look at the audits they do on the residential care, and you look at the villages and things, this is not what we're talking about. We're talking about people in those fantastic apartments and flash things. But it is, but a lot of more people, like in this particular case, are bed blockers, they're farmed out, they're put into rest homes. This is the DHB report on what happened to that guy. I mean, this is a human being. You know, he's not just a statistic, he was a human being. And there are other people in the same position, and you need something with the power and the authority that voice cannot be ignored.
We're going to have to leave it there, but thank you both very much for your time. I feel like I didn't earn my money tonight. I feel like that we had such an interesting debate, you guys could have just been left to it.
It's a great top policy.
Yeah.
It's a great opening here for you.
Well, good work, good lobbying. See, he never misses a chance. But we're going to go now.